Hello again. Make sure you got that periodic table. Apologies, by the way, for the sound quality. There seems to be an awful hiss in the background. That's not a snake. It's the poor quality microphone I've got, I believe. I'll try and get myself a USB one. Anyway, here we are now trying to find out formulas of ionic compound if we've given a name. Okay, that's the opposite of what we were doing in the last video. You can check for yourself that all of these compounds listed methyl, non-methyl compounds and therefore ionic. I can assure you they are, but it's always a good idea to check that. Okay, here we go then. So, first of all, we've got potassium chloride. Potassium chloride. I know that potassium is in group 1 over here, and its symbol is K. I also know that because potassium is in group 1, when it forms ions, it loses one electron and becomes a positively charged ion, K+. The second part of my compound is chloride, so that means it contains the element chlorine over here. Chlorine, a non-methyl, is in group 7. That means it has 7 electrons in its outer shell, and in order to form an ion, it would gain an extra electron. So it would become a negatively charged ion, Cl-. Now because these two ions, the positive and the negative, both have the same charge, we only need one of each of them in order to produce a compound which has zero charge. So the formula for our compound, KCl, potassium chloride. Magnesium oxide. Magnesium is in group 2, we've used that before. It's in group 2, has 2 electrons in its outer shell. When it reacts to form an ionic compound, it loses those 2 electrons to become a positively charged ion, but with 2 positive charges. Oxygen, over here, is in group 6, which means that it has 6 electrons in its outer shell, and in order to gain a full outer shell of electrons, it will gain 2, so it will get an extra 2 negative charges, so it become O2-. Again, the positive ion and the negative ion have exactly the same charge, so we only need one of each of those to produce a compound with no remaining charge. Aluminium. Now, aluminium is in group 3 over here, so it forms aluminium 3+ ions. Nitride, that infers that the element is nitrogen, is in group 5. It's in group 5, means it forms N3- ions. If it's in group 5, it has 5 electrons in its outer shell, it would then gain 3 extra electrons to get a full outer shell of electrons, but get an extra charge of 3-. Again, we only need one of each. So Al(n). The compound will have no overall charge. Now, magnesium nitrate. Well, nitrate means that we're looking at a polyatomic ion. Polyatomic ions over here. It's nitrate. It's NO3-. NO3 with one negative charge over the whole of the NO3. Magnesium's in group 2, we've looked at already, it's Mg2+. Now, the magnesium charge is twice as much as the nitrate charge, so we're going to need 2 of those nitrates to cancel out the 2+, and in order to write that, we must use brackets or parentheses to show that we have 2 complete NO3 particles. MgNO3 twice. Sodium oxide, Na, in group 1. We've worked out already that oxygen's in group 6, so it's O2-. So this time we need 2 Na pluses to balance the 2-. If we need 2 Na, we put the subscript after the Na, so there's 2 of them with NO2O. Potassium carbonate, Potassium we've done already is in group 1, K+. We have a polyatomic ion, we know that because we've got an 8 at the end, carbon 8, so carbon and oxygen, and that's over here, carbon 8, CO32 minus. So again, the negative charge is twice as much as the positive charge. So we need two potassiums. So we're going to write our formula as K2CO2. And last, but by no means least, we have iron 3 oxide. And this time we've got those Roman numerals inside the brackets after the metal. That's because iron can exist as more than one type of iron. You can see that up here, look, in our little list of transition metal ions. And the iron 3 means that the iron we're interested in here is Fe3+. And oxide, so O2-. So here we have a more tricky one, but we can see that if we have two of these and three of these, we get 6+ and 6-. Okay, we multiply that by 2, we multiply that by 3, we end up with 6+ and 6-, so we can write our compound as Fe2O3. Okay, I hope that helps. Again, the solutions to the other questions like that are on the blog, and of course if you have any questions, please ask your teacher in class or stop by during tutorial.